Hey guys.
So I know this wasn't scheduled. This is an impromptu live video. First, let me see if I can get on the feed so I can read any comments. There we go. Okay. All right. For anyone who is able to tune in, welcome. Hey, Linda. So today we're going to be playing with resin. I think I'm going to zoom in. I'm going to zoom in down on this canvas here real quick. Welcome, welcome, guys. Let's see. All right. Hopefully you guys can kind of see that. Oh, hey, Catherine. Welcome back. Long time no see. There we go. All right. So, I just have a couple ideas that I want to try out. Hey, WifeLife93, what up? Excuse me. So, I'm going to start by covering this canvas real quick with blue so that I don't have to worry about the white. Hey, Helen. Hey, Malik. I always have trouble pronouncing that one. Yeah, I kind of wanted to do an earlier in the day one because especially people like in the UK and whatnot. Yeah, they haven't been able to tune into my Monday night one. So I was like, oh, I'll throw one in on the weekend. Why not? Yeah, Catherine, how are you feeling? Better than last night, hopefully. All right, I really like this blue. This is Liquitex Basics. This is the phthalo blue. So I figure I'll cover this before I get started mixing up all my resins. And this way too, I can cover all the sides and not worry about it. All right, that was too much. Good, good. Everyone having a good Saturday so far? Because I don't know about you, but in LA it's pretty hot, but otherwise, nice weather. I'm about to go over to a friend's going away party. She's moving to Nashville, Tennessee. She's a musician. Her and her husband are moving. So, about to go over to her party. I wanted to get some painting done. Hey, everybody. Glad you're able to tune in. So I'm just getting the edges of this. Thought this was a pretty blue. So this will be my first, well, except for when I did the video with artists till death, this will be my first live resin video. So definitely take this opportunity to ask any questions and I'll do my best to answer. I'm super like not a complete pro yet and there's still so many resins and resin tints and everything to try out. It'll be a little while before I try everything out. All right. Catherine, why are you hiding her? Don't hide her, please. Anyways, okay. So, gonna use my gloves. How did you seal the desk? Resin is... you don't need to seal it. It's sealed already. Yeah. So, okay, Catherine. Well, just be careful on that. Okay, so Art Resin, which is what I'll be using today, has an awesome calculator on their website. So you can just put in the dimensions of whatever your canvas or surface is, and it'll tell you how much resin I need, or resin you need. So nervous. Well then, okay, so let me just tell you about art resin. Now, mind you, this is so far the only resin that I have used besides the ice resin, which I use for jewelry. Art resin is designed so that you can use it inside. That being said, I still wouldn't use it in an unventilated place or, you know, really small space. I would still, you know, make sure you got plenty of breathing room and everything like that. But this has like none of the harmful fumes and whatnot. So yeah, this is a decent one to use if you don't have a big, huge, well-ventilated space and whatnot. And then as I was saying, on their website, they have a calculator so that you can know exactly how much resin you need to use for whatever project you're doing. So for this size canvas, I only need 7 ounces. I'm gonna mix up a bit more though, because I wanna do some more of those petri dishes. So that will be exciting. So I'm mixing up extra here. And I'm gonna mix it all in this big cup. Hey Bugsy. Catherine, don't worry about it. All right. I'm not exactly sure how much I'm mixing up here because I didn't really measure it, but it's definitely more than 7 ounces. This is a 16-ounce cup. I think I mixed up probably about 9 ounces. I hope that's actually enough. Hey, Jackie. Yeah, you caught me live. I'm doing this for everyone on the other side of the world at this time. So, all right. You thoroughly stir this. You make sure you get all the sides. You make sure you get the bottom. You just gotta basically get everything really, really, really mixed up. All right, and then there's a little bit left in these cups. So I'm gonna now scrape that out into here. This stuff is expensive, guys. So you gotta make sure you use every drop possible. Don't wanna waste any of it. But it is a lot of fun, and you can totally get really cool effects that you can't get otherwise with just acrylic. You can also use it to just seal an acrylic painting, which is pretty cool. So, hey Jennifer. All right, mix this a bit more. Good, now we're going to mix up all our colors. And today I'm gonna be using resin better than acrylic. It's a little bit of a tough question because they're just so different. It's like apples to oranges. So it depends on what you're doing, I guess. I mean, like I said, resin's definitely more expensive. I do like that the resin dries within less than 24 hours, whereas an acrylic pour is gonna take definitely longer than that. It takes generally a couple days. So, yeah, there's different things that I like about each. Of course, the acrylic pouring is a lot cheaper and you can mess around with it a lot more. So I'm gonna be using 2 of the mica powders that I got from the Color Cottage. And then I'm gonna be using some of the resin tints, which is the coloring strictly from Art Resin. Hey, the Midgey Midge. Okay, so since this canvas isn't very large, I'm gonna be using my littler cups to mix the individual colors because you really don't need a lot, and a little bit goes a long way. Let's see, this one's a little bit bigger cup for some reason, I think. Now basically the ratio here is 1/10. I don't know how many colors I'm mixing. I know, right? Little adorable cups. I got one slightly bigger one. It's leftover from another batch. I'm gonna mix white in there. So you just need like really a few drops of the resin tint color, but it also depends on how translucent you want it. So this is turquoise. And then we've got purple. And then we've got black. And then this is blue. More surface, like a table of resin. Yep. And I'm toying with adding some copper in here. I don't know. All right, so let's see. So we're gonna add the totally teal. Oh no. I got a drop of some color in my white somehow. I don't even know how that happened. Yeah, definitely purple. I have two purples here. This mica powder is like a shimmery purple. Well, crud. Which one did I put the purple in? I don't remember. It's hard to tell. I think this is the purple. I'm gonna wait till I add the resin to be able to tell. This is the teal mica powder. Oh, that was a bit too much. Okay. Yeah, there is countertop epoxy. That is correct. So for doing furniture and whatnot, that would probably be a better bet. Just so you guys know. But sometimes you just work with what you got. And that's okay. All right. Let's get started. That's the turquoise right there. I think this is the purple. Yeah, that's the purple. Okay. This is black. This is the blue. And then this is the teal mica powder, which I really like. Okay, good. So I'm going to put a little bit of the purple mica powder in the purple. To give it that shimmery look. Hey, Mary. All right, add a little more in there. Okay. Hopefully that should be enough to do a couple of the petri dish kind of things. And you know, I probably mixed up more than enough colors to do two resin paintings. We'll see. All right, so mix really, really well, especially with the mica powders. With the resin tint, the liquid drops, you don't have to worry about it so much. They mix in very, very well, but with the mica powders especially, you need to mix in super duper well. Oh my gosh, that purple is gorgeous. I'm gonna put it in here. Hopefully you guys can see that. And these sticks don't like to stay in the cups. They like to just pop right out. All right, mix up white. I'm running out of sticks. So I'll probably have to double use some of these. I did get the sticks from Artist Till Death, the plastic reusable ones. I just have to clean them. Not bad. All right. These colors are similar enough. I'm just going to use the same stick here. Yeah, that purple is so pretty. That's the, I mixed it, but it's really the mica powder that I think is the really, really pretty. It's giving it that shine. I love the mica powders, they're so pretty. It's like gives it that like pearly look, you know? Okay. Mix up a couple more here. That's the black. And then we're gonna just go for it. Now from the doing the desk, my hair dryer got resined, so I can't press the buttons anymore. But if I plug it and unplug it, it works. So, all right, this background is dry. So I'm gonna just move everything out of the way and then we're gonna go for it. We're gonna just go for it. See what happens. Okay. Where I put my trash can. All right. Yeah, let's go for it. Okay, so I'm gonna, is this close enough, guys? Or do you want me to zoom in a little bit more real quick before I start? You know what, I think I'm gonna zoom in anyway. The purple is a mixture of mica powder and rest in peace hair dryer and the resin tints. Zoom, okay. I think that'll be good. Let's try a little bit more. Nope, too far. Sorry, guys. Okay. I think that's as good as it gets. For whatever reason, when you're live, the Zoom function is like super delicate and difficult. Okay. So, yeah, we're going to just get started here. I'm going to start with some of the white. And like I said, I kind of mixed up lots of resin, so I think I have more than enough. All right, let's get in there with this purple. Oh my goodness, so pretty. I didn't have a specific pattern in mind for today. I just want to make something pretty. So I think that's what we're going to do. This is the black. These are not special gloves at all. These ones are actually the regular latex gloves. Usually I use the other gloves, but yeah, these are just regular gloves. Okay, this is the blue, which is the resin tint. Didn't mix up a lot of that. All right, and then this is the teal mica powder, which is just gorgeous. All right. I'm gonna go right through the black here. And then let's do some over here. Okay. And then we'll go in with the turquoise. From the resin tint, and this is pretty translucent, guys. All right. So, if you don't like loud noises, cover your ears, because I am going to go in there with the hairdryer after I plug it in. Oh my goodness, you guys. That is stinking gorgeous. Can you guys see that? I'm going to go a little more straight down because of the light, the glare. Maybe a little bit hard to see. So I'm going to try to go a little more straight down here. 1 second, guys. There we go. Look at that. Okay. Woo, woo. Perfect. Art resin you can get online or at some art stores. Like locally for me, we have it at Blix. And then there's just other resins you can get other places. Michaels does have some resins, but the ones that I've researched from them are apparently not very good. The ones that they have on their shelves. So just make sure you research things before you buy them, of like, working time and the fumes and all that jazz, you know? Thanks, Johnson Jenny. I assume it's Jenny. I really appreciate that. All right, I'm so excited about this, guys. I don't know about you, but I am like crazy excited. This is gorgeous. So we're gonna just get all the edges covered here. Yeah, that's the other thing too, is some of the crappier resins, they yellow, which is one of the things that drew me to art resin specifically, is that it doesn't yellow. It's designed to last a long time. It's made by artists for artists. I sound like an advertisement for their website. I'm not sponsored by art resin, guys. And I will be trying out other resins. It just, that happens to be what I have right now. Hey, Tesla. Glad you were able to get in here. Hello, Linda. All right, so. Get in here with a little bit more. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and torch this real quick. I don't really know the rules, but I feel like I should be torching as I go along. So let's just go ahead and do that. Cause you know, it couldn't hurt. Okay. All right, we pretty much have the black and purple left. Can you use resin on Yuppo paper? I don't see why not. Pretty sure you can use it on just about anything. That's another cool thing about it. My friend saw the video I did of my sister's desk, and he wants me to try a resin pour on his car. I'm a little nervous about that, but I may just give it a go, because why not? Oh, the dogs are going crazy. Mailman must be here or something. Give it a little tilt. Maybe. A car, yeah. I know, right? Crazy. Yeah, I'm going to be trying out probably Mastercast next. Plus, I will be getting some of the countertop. I do have another friend, too, that does want me to do her countertops. Let's see. I'm going to go, I think, back through here. All right, yeah, we've got plenty. And hey, we didn't waste any. Okay. So, once again, guys, we're going to be taking a hairdryer to this. So, Turn your sound down if you do not want to hear that. Fair warning. That is really annoying to have to plug and unplug that. Okay. Yeah. I'm super happy with that. So let me just get, I'm going to get the edges here. And then we'll do a quick close up because I know it's a little bit hard to see with all the glare. And I'm definitely really happy that I painted that background blue first because of using the translucent pigments. I sound so fancy saying things like that. The translucent pigments. Anyways, sorry. Yeah, you can totally see through them. So it just blends really well with that blue, I think. All right. The other thing about resin is I definitely find myself going through a lot of pairs of gloves. More than with the acrylic. Because I don't want to get resin all over everything. Paint you can just wash off. Resin, not so much. Aw, thank you, Wayne. Really appreciate that. Oh, you guys are so awesome. Thanks, Angela. You guys rock. Okay, let's do our close-up here. I'm just... like stupid happy with how this came out here. All right, I'm gonna move this real quick. So close your eyes if you need to. Yeah, absolutely. You can definitely use clear. I mean, some parts like right here, you can see the color is so translucent that it's literally just the background color. There's the purple. Now guys, in this light, it looks a little more pinkish, but it's really, really purple. So I'm going to zoom out a little bit. No, I'm not. Okay, because it's too hard. All right. Over here is that mica powder, the teal. See how glossy that is? Got the white. That white through there is just awesome. Yeah, the colors float. They do. I love it. Love it, love it. I'm glad you guys do too. So there you go. The full picture without too much glare. That's not bad at all. So you can see it looks more purple. Hey, Judith. You didn't miss it. We're going to be doing a couple projects here, so. And plus, I didn't really tell anybody about this. All right, I'm putting it back on the tripod, so it's going to shake around. So just be prepared for that. It's going to be shaking. There we go. Let's get this positioned correctly again. I know, right? I want to try a countertop too. So like I said, I have a friend that wants me to do her countertop. So I'm going to try to push her to get let me do that really soon. How are you going to pick it up? Oh, I'm not worried about that. It'll be fine. Remember, the paint's going to keep moving, so even though I'm going to touch the sides for a second, the resin will keep moving over that. I'm just going to prepare my drying space real quick and then move it over to there. Then I'm going to have a couple sips of coffee, and then we're going to do the next project. Okay. Gloves back on. Oh, yeah, I gotta torch this actually real quick before I move it anyways. All right, somehow I find the one you didn't tell anyone about, but not the others. I know, right? Yeah, somehow you guys all found the secret live video. It's not really a secret. Okay, now just as a note about the torching, you do have to move it around really fast for anyone that's never used a torch, especially with the resin, because you will definitely light it on fire. I torched that desk so much, there was one part that I literally almost lit on fire. It started decently smoking, freaked me out. So, just words of wisdom there. Stopped housework for this. Oh, this is way better than housework. Why isn't the musician playing in the background? Well, you know, sometimes he does other things. Sometimes. Not often, but sometimes. Okay. Moving this over to my safe drying area. Good. All right, we're gonna do some of these resin petri dish things now. So for this, we're using these things. I'm not gonna use that one. All right, I'm actually gonna zoom in a bit more because you guys are gonna wanna see real close up for this, like real close up, so. Gonna do my best not to make it a dizzying effect. Yeah, you can use a heat gun instead of a torch as well. It's really not scary. Just, you know, apply common sense. Don't torch the same area for like 20 minutes, you know. All right. Ooh, there we go. Nice and zoomed in. All right. Oh, come on. Here we go. Okay. I already took a glove off, so new gloves again. Okay. All right, so I think I have enough resin here to do at least two. So let's go ahead and pour this in here. Actually, I might have enough to do three. Yeah, buddy. All right, we're going to do three. Now, of course, people have asked me, what do you do with these? These can be used as coasters. They can, I'm going to actually be drilling a hole through them, probably, and hanging them as, like, really cool, window ornaments and whatnot, and around Christmas time, everyone's probably gonna get a resin ornament. So double glove before the pour. Oh my gosh, you're so smart. So smart. Okay. I almost forgot to take my coffee. All right. Have you ever used syringes? I have not. Okay. Anyways, long story short, there's a lot of things that you can do with these. So we're going to play around a bit today. And this is the Pinata White. So we're going to start with this one. This one we're going to just do regular. I'm not going to twirl it around or anything. We're going to just go crazy with it. So apparently the white is specifically what you need to create the cool, like, dropped effect where it looks like it's like falling down into it. I'm also going to add a little bit of silver because I think that helps produce the same effect. Are you guys still there? Did I time out? Hold on. I think I'm still there, but oh, good, you are there. Okay, so my computer just froze. Okay, there we go. It unfroze. Dropping beads or glitter or whatever would be cool too. So let's put a couple. That's the silver, guys. I know it looks a lot like the white, especially on camera. Yeah, the movement is so fun. Like, literally could just watch these all day. Okay, this is Ranger. This color is called Stream. It's like a teal color. And then I'm gonna use some of the Pinata Purple. Hey, Helen. We were just quietly watching. Okay. Yeah, that might have been it too. I'm like, oh no, everybody left. Ooh, almost missed. All right. And then we're gonna put the white, a little white back in here too. All right. I think a couple more colors. I'm going to do green. This is the Pinata Rainforest Green. Just put a couple drops of that. All right. I think that's good for that. I'm going to just let that kind of go crazy. Super awesome, I know, right? All right, now we're going to mess around with these other two. And we're gonna see what different effects we can create. So, once again, starting with some white, I'm going to take a toothpick and we're gonna swirl this around to get kind of a smoky effect. And then we're gonna, let's do colors in like sections here. So that's that. We'll do some yellow. Can't get rid of us until you stop the live video. That's good. Here are all my hostages. Whoa, whoa, whoa. All right, let's go with some yellow over here. And then let's do a bit of red. And then lastly, we'll do a bit of pink. Which, oddly enough, when mixed with that teal, made purple, which is a bonus. All right, I also have a little black. And then I'm gonna put, this is the Pinata Black, so I find the Pinata colors a little bit heavier. Whoa, that was an accident. That was way more than I meant to do. That's okay. My bad. All right, let's go back in here with a little bit of the white. That was crazy. And then we're gonna go back in with some color. All right, so back in here with the green, the yellow, the red, and the pink. All right, I think we're gonna leave that one. That one looks fun. Okay. Fingers are not cooperating, right? Whoa. Okay. Yeah, Artists Till Death, they do live videos literally every day, and they pretty much solely do resin, I think. So yeah, if you like really, really want to learn resin, I would definitely recommend checking out their channel. All right. Unfortunately, this table is not like 100% level, but that's okay. All right. Now I think I want to do this one a little monochromatic. I don't even know. Is that a word? Did I just make that up or is that a correct word? Somebody let me know. Where's the grammar police? Wow, somebody literally named themselves Troll Alert. Yeah. Thank you, Wife Life. It is a word. Yes. Monochromatic. Okay. Now, if I'm correct, that is using like one color, but maybe different shades. So this maybe not entirely fit that definition, but we're going to do black and white here. So first I'm going to take a toothpick. This is silicone, not plastic. So I'm going to take a toothpick and I'm going to swirl this around a bit. That's so cool. Okay, good. Yeah, silicone, guys. And then I'm gonna go in with a little bit more white. I'm gonna throw a couple drops. I know, right? Love the black and white. I'm gonna throw a couple drops of one color. I think I'm gonna go with purple. I know, I like it too, but okay, one drop of purple. One. All right, and then once again, I'm gonna swirl this around a bit. Cool. One more drop of white to help bring out that purple a bit more. Now the goal is definitely not to like get this all mixed up. There we go. All right. Let's go ahead and we'll do, yeah, it's like a galaxy. Multiple shades of the same color. So yeah, multiple shades of the same color. All right, and those are gonna continue to move, of course, but let's do a close up for how they look now. And then if you guys tune in probably tomorrow, I'll do maybe like a quick live where I just do a reveal kind of thing of these guys. And I'll show you the other resin painting dry as well. Okay, here's the first one. This is the party in a cup. yeah, so you can see, can you guys see that depth there? Where you can see the blue actually underneath that white. And there's a little pink down there as well. I'm very excited about that. Here's that second one, which is like a rainbow. And I'm really curious how the other side will look. Very curious. And then here is my monochromatic, possibly, one. Not quite sure if it fits that definition, but I think so. I think it's good enough for me. And there you go. What are these going to be? I'm not totally sure. I think I'm going to make some really cool kind of window ornaments out of them, like stained glass kind of idea. But we'll see, you know. I don't have any set. Okay, so these, just so you guys know, in case I wasn't clear, I did use two different kinds of alcohol inks in here. So I used the Ranger, the Tim Holtz ink. Let me hold that up here. The Tim Holtz alcohol ink. These are definitely pretty thin. And then I also used the Pinata inks, which are a lot thicker. So the Pinata inks, I think, help the color sink down. Could be wrong, but I think they do. And yeah, there we go. So I'm gonna quickly, really quickly torch these. Okay, good. There we go. And we're gonna leave it. I know, right? It does kind of suck that we have to wait until tomorrow to see these dry. But anyways, large mold and made something around the lines of bird bath. That would be crazy, but definitely possible. Yeah, I like the different inks for different things. You know, I wouldn't necessarily say one's better than the other. Just they have their different uses, you know. Okay, kids. I think that's all we're going to do for today. Any last minute quick questions before I time out? Don't worry, wife life. Perfect timing. Yeah, I'm definitely going to do some molds in different shapes. Also, once I figure out how to accurately drill a hole in here, which I think I have already, I'm going to make some really killer necklaces so I can use all the different molds to make really cool necklaces. So that's definitely on the lineup on the agenda. Cool. Golden's High Flow Acrylics. You can, it just won't have the same effect. You can definitely use acrylic paints. It's totally different than the alcohol, though. Something about the way the alcohol inks specifically react with the resin creates these effects. So, and I think that was how long does it take to dry, which these take about 24 hours to dry. So, yeah, precision drill bit. All right, you're going to have to be a little more clear than Trey question mark. Is it what kind of tray is this or what is this? This is silicone. Yeah, silicone mold. All right, guys, have a...